Boise, Idaho, and we're in part in existence because of the Knox Brothers. Yesterday, I was in Mexico on a cruise ship, and we did a gospel music celebration on a cruise ship, and then went into San Diego, and I flew to Oakland, and then to home, and I got in my bed at 1 a.m. this morning in Boise, Idaho, and I hopped in my car earlier this morning, and I headed over here. I was not going to miss this retirement celebration. I was really taken back there when they were talking about this bus. How many feet long was it, the one that you had 17 people in? 35-foot bus, 17 people for 6 weeks. We have a 45-foot bus. We took 17 people on a trip to California for 6 days and came back with 4 people. Knowing the Knox Brothers, they probably went with 17 people. After 6 weeks, they had about 20 people when they came back. They have been so instrumental in my life, and I was a music minister up in Portland, First Nazarene, and we would come down to Harrisburg and watch them sing with the Cathedrals and the Florida Boys, and man, oh man, I'm telling you, what a legacy this group has. And I get emotional thinking about the influence, the ripples of lives as they've changed through gospel music and their ministry. And every time I think about the Knox Brothers, I think of the song, "May all who come behind us find us faithful." They've been faithful over these 48 years. Let's stand and welcome back for the second half.